This is not a matter of conjecture or wistful thinking. Theodore C. Loder III, Ph.D., Professor Emeritus of Earth Sciences, University of New Hampshire. Again, to access the official files pertaining to this particular case, you can visit the government's Project Blue Book files to read them.
want to live a very, very superficial life, and that superficiality temporarily satisfies you, or you really don't care.
What if I illegally moved to Mexico and waved the American flag while demanding in English that the Mexican people pay for my way? Or what if I moved to a Muslim country and demanded that they make accommodations for my Christian faith? What would happen to me?
I want you to get up right now and go to the window, open it, and stick your head out and yell, I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not gonna take this anymore! I want you to get up right now. Get up, go to your windows, open them, and stick your head out and yell, I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not gonna take this anymore! Things have gotta change!
How many stations does this go on?
67. I know it goes to Louisville,
Atlanta. I'm not gonna take this anymore! Then we'll figure out what to do about the depression and the inflation and the oil crisis. But first, get up out of your chairs!
Because you don't want to be free. You don't even want to be human. Because you don't want to be free. You don't even want to be human.
Each group of Illuminati is constantly striving to increase its power base and undermine the competition.
If anybody actually believes that they're not trying to kill us off and not trying to mind control us and not trying to change us and control us in every aspect of our life, I don't know what to tell you.
why keep a secret about probably one of the most important events in history, that there's been contact from an alien civilization?
Thank you. I said, okay, one last thing. I've been hearing that you must be an initiated witch now to get a record contract. He said, that's right. He said, many of us that weren't total witches have to be witches now in order to produce music.
Thank you.
After it's been recorded, it's taken in. This is why a master's cut months in advance before it's released. On the full moon, it's taken in to a temple room about the size of this auditorium that is in every one of the major music companies behind locked doors up in the executive office. It's placed on an altar sitting in the north of the room and a pentagram engraved in the floor. And 13 hand-chosen witches and wizards and a coven come in and conjure a principality or a power up, usually Regia or something like that, and order him to tell the demons under him to follow every record and every tape coming off of that master. As I tell many Christian parents, you can go home and count your kids' records, probably yours too, and count how many demons at least are there. That's too hard for you to believe? I'm sorry. That's why they do it. It's not just a song. It is supernatural music that witches carefully designed by their spirit guides or familiar spirits in the form of spells. Now, although the devil's music's power is the music and God's music is the word, much of the songs are written.
And I remember right before I performed, I raised my hands up, and it was kind of the first time I felt something else come into me, and I knew that was going to be my coming out night. But right before I performed, I raised my hands up, and it was kind of the first time I felt something else come into me.
Thank you.
3 years worth of brujeria. Yes, you know I gotta scrape all this up. I got my sandblaster, my goggles. It's about to go down.
Det måste ju varit antingen en synvilla eller en ubåt då. Hoppas att det inte var en ubåt. För Sveriges skull. Mm.